Hi, I'm Dolph Schluter. I'm a professor in the zoology department and interim director of the Biodiversity Research Center. I study how new species form and become different from one another. My main study organism is the three-spine stickleback. The three-spine stickleback occurs throughout the northern hemisphere in coastal waters, and the marine species has been in the sea for a long time, but particularly in this part of the world, it has colonized freshwater over and over again. And to understand how these freshwater populations formed, we have to realize that 13,000 years ago, the land where I am now sitting was covered by ice about a kilometer and a half thick. And this ice melted over the next 1,000 to 2,000 years. And the ice was really heavy, but with the weight of the ice removed, the land rebounded and new lakes were formed, and the marine form was able to colonize freshwater at that time. So when we looked at the genes, we discovered two things that we did not expect. The gene variant that benthics have on different islands where these pairs evolved independently, we discovered that the gene variants in the benthics from two lakes were more closely related to each other than either is to the variant present in the limnetic species or in the marine species. The second result that we did not expect when we looked at the genes is that the benthic variant, although it arose from the variant that we see today in the limnetics and also in the marine form, the benthic variant is older than the lakes. Not only is it older than the lakes, it's older than the species. And it's not just a few years older, it's millions of years older. How is this even possible? No existing freshwater stickleback population is millions of years old. So our hypothesis is that these old variants are kept in circulation by persistent gene flow between marine and freshwater populations. Here we see the ice retreating, coastal lands rebounding, and the marines colonizing freshwater. But these marines carried genes with them from older populations. Here we show a freshwater population and a marine population meeting where the stream meets the ocean and interbreeding and producing a hybrid. And this hybrid individual has both marine variants and freshwater variants. The freshwater variants are indicated by the stripes. This hybrid joins the marine population and interbreeds with marine individuals generation after generation. And after every generation, the hybrid offspring, well, they range in the number of freshwater variants that they possess. But gradually, the freshwater genotypes become scattered. And what's produced in the end is a marine population where every individual, or at least most individuals, carries maybe one or two variants that are inherited from an interbreeding event that happened with the freshwater population a long time ago. Now the ice recedes, a new lake is formed, the marines colonized, and they bring with them some of this variation. And over time, within this lake, offspring are produced, and some of them carry 0, 1, 2, or 3 of these genes with the freshwater variants. And those individuals that inherit more copies of freshwater variants do better on average. They survive better and they produce more offspring. And this is the process of natural selection. And eventually, over a number of generations, we produce a freshwater population that is very much like the freshwater population that long ago interbred with the marine form and injected it with these variants. One of the things we learned from stickleback and the genetic studies of stickleback is that new species can evolve rapidly, and that when they do so, they often make use of genes that formed a long time ago. And so new species can often be made up, at least in part, by old genes. And we are finding that that seems to be a common story now that we're finding in other systems around the world that other people are working on, especially when new species evolve very rapidly.